Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial. Today we're going to look at creating gouache effects in Illustrator. If you're unfamiliar with them, this is the kind of thing that a gouache effect is. It's often done as an engraving, a series of repeated lines slightly offset from each other, and you can create some really interesting patterns using gouache effects. So I have a standard document open here in Illustrator. It's 1920 by 1080 pixels in size. It doesn't really matter how big your document is. I'm going to start with a spiral. So I'm going to select the spiral tool. It shares a toolbar position with the line segment tool. I'm going to just set this with a stroke, but no fill at all. That will allow us to create lines and actually see the lines as we repeat them. So I'll click once in the document. We can just have a quick look at my spiral settings. It's a radius of about 270. None of this is set in concrete, just use some approximate values. Decay is 80, segments 10, and I'm going in a clockwise direction. So I'll click OK. I'm going to rotate this spiral around. And what I want as my end result is to continue this line down to sort of meet where the bottom of the spiral is, but I don't want it to roll back in. I want it to be either sort of straight or out slightly. That's going to help when we create the brush in a minute. So let's just tip this around a little bit further. Now I'm going to reset my bounding box because you see my bounding box is offset. So I'll choose Object Transform, Reset Bounding Box. And let's go to the pen tool. I'm going to locate the anchor point here. I'll click and drag to continue it and then come down here so that I'm directly opposite the bottom of the spiral and just click once. To stop this from drawing, I'll press the escape key. So now I have my first spiral. I want a second one reflected. So I'll choose Object Transform Reflect. I'm going to reflect across the vertical, turn preview on so you can make sure it's working, and click copy because you want the original and a copy. We'll select just one of these spirals and start moving them apart. And what I'm looking for is to create a result here with these two spirals that looks interesting. So you can just sort of move them until you find a spot where something interesting is happening. The symmetry looks interesting. So I'm at this point now, I'll select over both of these objects, and now to create these fine lines, we're already working with a stroke of 1 pixel for this line set, that'll be pretty good. So selecting over both shapes, I'll choose Effect, Distort and Transform, and then Transform. I'll turn Preview on and I'm going to transform relative to the bottom of this spiral. So I'll click here in the middle of these 9 boxes. And what I'll do is reduce this shape down to 97% of what it was previously each step. So you can see that the original is out here and this is what the next line is going to look like. So let's add some more copies and some more copies and some more copies until we get something interesting. For this, I'm using 90 copies. You might need to use more or less. At this point, if you wish to do so, you could even shrink this up a little bit. So you're distorting it from that nice spiral into something that looks like this. It's just fine. So before I create this as a brush, what I want to happen for my brush is I want it to paint along a line so that the line will sit across the foot of the brush. And to do that, we're going to have to do some fancy footwork. So let's have a look. We'll choose View and then Rulers and then Show Rulers. I'll drag down a ruler or a guide from here and I want to line it up to the very bottom of this spiral. I'm just going to zoom in and make sure that it's lined up, which it isn't. And I will just move this guide down. Control or Command 0 to zoom back out. So this is a guide and that will help me line things up in just a minute. Next, I'll go to the pen tool and I'm going to target a point. It doesn't matter where it is in this horizontal line, but it does matter that vertically it is right at the top along the same line as the top of this spiral. I'm just locating it here with the smart guides and click once to create it. So I've created an anchor point. You can see that I'm attached to that anchor point. If I press escape, I'll still have that anchor point. It's still selected and the pen tool has stopped drawing. So we'll go back to the selection tool. You can see my anchor point is selected. I want to reflect that over this line here. To do that, I'll go to the reflect tool. I'll target the reflect tool and then hover over the guide that we just created. We did the guide because it just makes it really easy to pinpoint this position. Hold the Alt or Option key as you click on the guide. We're going to reflect over the horizontal, so we've moved the dot from here all the way down to here. We don't need to make a copy, we can just click OK. Now I don't need my guide anymore at this point. It was just there to pick up that point a little bit more accurately. So let's go and find the guide. It's here, it's just an object like every other object in Illustrator. I've got it selected, I'll press delete to delete it. So to make our brush, we're going to select this object here and this dot that's sitting just down there. So let's make a big selection there. Your selection should look like this. So you should have a big empty space here that will make sure that the brush is going to paint along a line. Open up the brushes panel, click the new icon. We're going to create a pattern brush. We'll click OK. Now, if you don't see these corner tiles, if you're working with an earlier version of Illustrator, that's fine. We're only going to be working in circles today. But if you're working in a later version of Illustrator, you can create your own corner tiles for working with squares or polygons. We'll set the colorization method to tint so we can recolor this line and click OK. Now I'm just going to move my selection out of the way because I don't need it any longer. So let's just move it off the edge there. I'll drag out a circle, click on the ellipse tool, shift as I drag out a circle. Now, right now I've got a no fill, no stroke circle. I need to have a stroke on it, so I'll just click color and it's black, that's fine. We'll go to the brushes palette and click on our brush. It's always the last element in the brushes palette, the most recently created brush. So I'll just click on it once. So the brush has been applied to the shape. Let me just size the shape down a little bit. It's been repeated 3 times around the shape, but by selecting the shape, we can change the number of repeats. I'll click here on Options of Selected Object, which is in the bottom of the brushes panel. This allows me to change the brush properties for just this instance of the brush. Turn preview on so you can see what's happening, and you'll want to scale it down to a point at which you get 6 shapes. Now there's some variation here. It's not always going to be 60%, and there will be some percentages that you can use that will all give you this same result because we're using stretch to fit. So Illustrator is going to sort of even this out. So there's a fair bit of wiggle room between getting 7 shapes and getting 5 shapes. So you just want to find the point at which you get 6 shapes. 6 shapes because the mathematics is just easier. So what I want to do is, because I've got 6 shapes, that means that the angle between each of these shapes is 60 degrees. So the space in here is 30 degrees. It's half of that distance. Let's use that 30 degrees. I'll choose Object Transform. I'm going to rotate this shape around 30 degrees. So I've got 30 degrees selected, but I'm going to make a copy as well as the original. So now I've got 2 shapes, and this is a classic sort of galoche look, if you like. Let's have a look in the layers palette. We've got 2 ellipses. Let's recolor them different colors. So let's choose a sort of bluey green for one and a sort of dark mustard or brown for the other. And at its simplest, that's how you create a galoche effect. You're looking for some sort of repetitive element and then layering things on top of each other using colors to sort of blend them together. Before we leave, let's create an element to go in the middle of this shape. Now, to prove that your elements don't have to be as intricate as this, let's have a look at creating our middle element using the pencil tool. So I'm just going to grab the pencil tool. Let's kick over to a black line just so we can see things. I'm using a thin black line, but I don't want a brush. So let's just go back to the basic brush and I'll just use a 1 pixel line. Okay, so with my pencil tool, I'm just going to draw a sort of squiggle. Nothing magical here at all. I'll select over it and I'll just squeeze it up a little bit. I'm going to locate the middle of this circle, so I'm interested in what this point is. So let me just go to the transform panel so we can read off this point. It's at 1000.5 and 527.5. Well, let's just move it. Let's put it at 1500. And that's just move those shapes. So I know this point now is at 1500. Now let's go and select this shape here, and I want to put this dot here at that same position. So let's go and locate that point, which is the middle of the left-hand side series of boxes. And I'm going to set this at 1500. So that's just lining this squiggly line up with the middle of the circle. It's just going to give us a balanced result. I'm going to drag this in because I want it to be sort of around about this point here. And I'm going to rotate this. So I'll choose Effect, Distort and Transform, and then Transform, exactly the tool we've been using so far. We want to transform around this point here, so I'll click on that point. Let's turn Preview on. And what we'll do is just rotate this. So let's try 3 degrees of rotation and let's increase the number of copies. What you will want to make sure when you're doing this is that you're using a number of degrees that will divide evenly into 360, so you don't have anything left over. 3 will go into 360 120 times. So what you'll do is you'll say, okay, I need 120 of these shapes. I've got one original, I need 119 copies. So that means that you don't have any duplicates. You haven't gone too far, in other words. If you wanted to use 4, then you could use 90 as your multiplier. So 4 degrees, we would need 90 shapes. So that would be 89 plus one original. And so that we're getting this effect in the middle. And if you look at it, it's also a sort of Guilloche effect. It's got the same look as these elements, but it's been created with a line that we drew with the pencil tool. And we drew it unevenly because we wanted to get something interesting out of it. So again, I can select on this shape and just change the color. And so we have a middle to our Guilloche shape. You can create these Guilloche shapes using all sorts of tools. You're just looking for perhaps some symmetry or something interesting in terms of line work. You're going to rotate it multiple times so that you get the buildup of this effect, and there you have it. I hope you've enjoyed learning these Illustrator techniques. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.